The Wheat School on RealAgriculture.com is brought to you by CNMC, Syngenta Canada, and the Alberta Wheat Commission.
Peter Johnson at Wheat Pete, RealAgriculture.com, and we are going to talk about growth regulators, big wheat staging, because man, wheat is worth $7 a bushel and we got to chase as many bushels as we can. So let's start at the beginning with the small wheat. So here's a field of wheat that was planted late October, early November. We frost seeded some of this and a beautiful stand. But man, when you look at that stand, there's enough plants there, but there's not enough stems. We really want more stems. So we need to get more stems. How do we do that? Great question. Well, let's look at it. So first off, the zatic stage, pretty simple to understand. If you look at, one is leaves, two is tillers. So the plant on the right has no tillers, but it has three leaves. One is leaves, three is three leaves, so that's growth stage 13. Not much we can do there other than we'd really like to stimulate more stems in that if we could at all. The middle plant, it's now starting to tiller. So two is tillers, one is leaves, two is tillers. It's got one tiller, so that means growth stage 21. The plant on the left, it's growth stage 22 because it's got two tillers. I've pulled the leaves back so you can actually see those tillers quite easily. So now you say, okay, Johnson, that's all fine. I really don't care to stage that. That's all malarkey to me, but okay. But what do I do to get more tillers? Awesome question. So there's products out there, gibberellic acid products. Gibberellic acid is a natural plant growth hormone, and it should stimulate more tillering. And so we've tried that, but it's as if these small plants, they simply don't have enough photosynthate, enough energy in the plant to utilize those growth regulators applied at this stage. We haven't been able to get them to tiller more. I would say do a plot, absolutely, see if it can work for you. We haven't had success on this small wheat. Where we have had success, early nitrogen. This year, the guys that put early nitrogen on, man, they made more tillers. The growers with this late planted wheat that didn't do that, no, they are struggling for tillers. They are not going to have as good a yield. So nitrogen is always the best growth regulator. So now let's move on to where we really get into where you have to pay attention to staging. So now we're at growth stage 30. What does growth stage 30 mean? It means that we've moved past the tillers. And by the way, tiller stage is kind of cool. On some of this big wheat, we have wheat that has 11 tillers per plant. Well, if two is tillers and 11 tillers, what stage is that? It's 211, right? Because two is tillers and, oh, anyway, we never get to that. We don't talk about that, but that's sort of the growth stage you'd be at. Anyway, growth stage 30. How do we look at that? So here's some September the 23rd wheat. And man, it's a nice stand. You can see it's tillered well. It's got lots of stems. And we didn't want to stimulate more tillers. This is a lodging prone variety. So until we hit growth stage 30, we didn't want nitrogen because if we put nitrogen on and stimulated more tillers, we'd have too many. Now we're at growth stage 30. How do we tell that? The only way is we have to actually dig plants out. As we dig the plant out, notice that the roots, the crown, is always at 3/4 of an inch. So that's a good thing to remember. It helps us stage the plant. But we dig those plants out. We have to take that knife and we have to actually carefully slice right down through the middle of that plant and open it up. And when we open it up, what are we looking for? Development of that tiny head. And in this plant, perfect, bingo. You can see where the knife is pointing. We are right on that stage. We have a little tiny head and it's just moved ever so much above the crown. Growth stage 30. Now, on that wheat that has the right number of tillers, get the nitrogen on. Save the tillers you have, get big heads, support that growth. We want that nitrogen on at this stage. It's also the right stage for when we can start to use the growth regulators, the manipulator. This year we just have manipulator. Next year we hope to have manipulator and Modus. Modus didn't make it through the system this year, but that's the beginning of that stage. After that, once we hit growth stage 30, from now on, we no longer have to slice stems. I know nobody likes slicing stems. Fair enough. Why don't we have to slice stems? because that growing point starts to move up the stem. The stems are hollow. The growing point moves above, including the node, above the ground. Grow stage 31. Well, now the growing, that first node is above the ground. Go to the ground level. You can crush the stem. You can feel it crush. You go up. You feel the bump. Yep, that's the first node stage. With grow stage 31. Three is stem elongation, the node stage three, one node 31. 32, well now, as you can see in this next plant, all of that stem elongation has really moved the head above the ground, and the first node stops, the head starts to move away from the first node. We can now squish our fingers between the first node and the second node. When that gets to be an inch, that's growth stage 32. This plant isn't quite growth stage 32, but it's definitely getting close, and that's the end of the perfect window for those growth regulator applications. We'd really like to get them in between that growth stage 30 and growth stage 32. They'll still work past growth stage 32. They're not as efficacious. So that's a really kind of crux of the issue. What about this really big wheat? Once we get to really big wheat, and look at this wheat field, man, we got to do a better job of reducing seeding rates, but that's okay. We'll talk about that another time. You get wheat that looks like this, you actually have to hold your nitrogen off. You can see that the plants here, they're starting to go yellow. They're backing off, and we're holding that nitrogen because if we don't withhold the nitrogen and drop some tillers, we get so much plant-to-plant competition that we just, they stretch for sunlight and they become more lodging prone. Now, if you have a really good variety for standability, maybe on that September, this is September the 10th wheat, maybe you don't need a growth regulator, but man, you have to consider it. And if you have a poor variety for standability, I think this early planted wheat growth regulators are an absolute must.